Hi, my name is David Sommerfleck. I'm a digital marketing specialist online at dms.blue. This question I'm answering is, what are the best strategies for a startup business to get testimonials for its products or services? Now, who cares about testimonials, right? Well, actually, studies have shown conclusively that testimonials do matter, that they do actually make consumers, who are your ideal target market, feel better about working with you. I don't know about you watching out there, and you can let me know. Personally, I've looked up many, many doctors, other service providers, and if they have testimonials from people who look like, you know, normal humans, not perfect male models and other, you know, female models, but people who look like average, you know, working day people, it's more convincing. You're willing to work with them and part with your hard-earned money if you really feel like, hey, this guy could really help me. So in studies have shown that in almost all cases, having testimonials really does help in terms of marketing. It also aids in transparency. You know, ever since I started as a digital marketing guru guy back in the 90s, I've always had testimonials from people, because even if what they say isn't always grammatically correct or doesn't look perfect, it just shows that, hey, look, these are real people who said, you know, this guy did good work for me. It's comforting. It just moves things along. So it is important, and it does help you, and studies have shown that. So what are the best strategies for a startup to get testimonials for its products or services? My answer is, and again, I don't know about this business. I don't know what they do, what products they sell or services they provide. So here are some of my suggestions to start collecting testimonials to get that ball rolling. Number one, if you live in a large metropolitan city, I would pay the small fee with meetup.com to create 3 meetup groups. Now, the way meetup works is you pay a monthly fee. I think it's $15 a month or something, and you're allowed to create up to 3 groups. You don't have to create 3, but you're allowed up to 3 groups, and you can make the 3 groups look different, and you should. And you can use different search terms, or they call them topics. And what you do is you create these 3 groups. You use different search topics who are basically for the type of audience that you want to reach. For example, lawyers or doctors or manufacturers, if you live in a large metropolitan city. If you don't live in a large metropolitan city, this may not work for you, because there just may not be enough people, or the people there could just be hobbyists, you know, looking for things to do on a Saturday or whatever. So you can waste your time with people who are nice, but just never going to really, don't want to spend any money. They just want something fun to do to pass the time or whatever. I remember I had a group helping people with digital marketing, and I remember there was an elderly man who came once and said his wife had recently passed away. He felt really depressed and lonely and just wanted to come and learn what this new digital thing was, basically. And I felt so terrible. Oh my God. You know, what do you say to that? You know, I'm so sorry your wife just passed away, sir. Whatever you want to know, just ask, okay? But it's obvious he's not going to work with you. He just wants something to build it past the time. So if you're not in a large city, it may not work. So create the 3 groups that look different, have different search topics. Direct those, obviously, that's to the same location at the same date and time. And you basically have like a 1 or 2 hour meeting where you meet with your ideal consumers and you go over, hey, these are my products and or services. This is how I believe they can help you. What questions or issues do you see so I could refine them or make them work better for you? Would you test out my services or products in exchange for giving me testimonials? If you can get video testimonials, that's even more powerful. And most library conference rooms, most libraries will let you use their conference rooms for free or for $10 or something, especially if it's open to the public and nothing that would scare them or be disreputable or anything like that. if you can't get a library to let you use their space, you can also go to a co-working facility, which is in most cities, where again you pay something for an hour and you can use the room to interview people or just have like a networking group. You discuss things and just put it in a casual kind of way where you're willing to help people with these types of problems using your services or products and just see how it works. Next, I'd get in touch with local companies who would also be ideal consumers for your services or products. I'd inform them about the meetings and ask them if they'd like to send someone to test out these services or goods. If they blow you off or don't respond, don't take it personally, because again, studies have shown that people need to see something 7 times before they'll respond. This was in a study cited by the New York Times. Next and last, I would get in touch with complementary business owners, not direct competitors, and ask if they would like to get involved, but only if you know in advance how they can benefit and form a mutually beneficial relationship or partnership with you. So it's sort of like in the movies, they'd have a really, really smart little guy who would make friends with a really big guy. Well, the big guy would protect the little guy because the little guy was small. It would kind of be like me as a digital marketing guy making friends with a graphic designer. I may not be Leonardo da Vinci with graphic design, and by the same token, a graphic designer may not be proficient in SEO or content marketing or how to put everything together as a whole. So it would be mutually beneficial to be friends or have a working relationship with a graphic designer, or for that matter, a content provider, or someone who is an expert in SEO, because I may be too busy to do it, or may want to get really deep down in a pay-per-click program or something. So it's always good to have friends and relationships with others who perform complementary or overlapping work so that you have someone to refer back to. And occasionally you can team up on projects if they're open to it. In some cases they're not, or they just don't see it. So that's why you have to know in advance how you're going to promote this and try to solicit interest. So the final thing I would do is run some ads on Facebook, because Facebook advertising is still very affordable and reaches over 2 billion people a day. So I would run some ads on Facebook targeting your ideal consumer group. And then I would give this about 60 days. And in fact, I would give everything that I just suggested 60 days. Then I would go back after those 60 days, I'd pause everything and I would reassess and see everything that I did, how many leads did I get from this? Did it achieve the objective that I wanted to get done? And I would be willing to wager that if you did everything that I suggested in unison for 60 days, you'll see some traction. So I hope this answer is helpful. To learn more or get help with digital marketing or growing your business in general, visit me at dms.blue. And thanks for watching.